Hi everyone, I'm Shima. Welcome back to our channel. So last week we shared with you on why we don't culture crab in the bioflop. So in this video we will be discussing, is it good to culture shrimp in clear water recirculating aquaculture system, or also known as RAS? So typical clear water recirculating aquaculture system have external filtration devices to maintain adequate water quality. For example, the sand filter, UV filter and biofilter. However, there are also a few goods and bads in the system which you need to focus on. So some of the advantages clear water RAS include a high level system control, limited oxygen demand of biological filtration, and the filtration system can be expanded according to the culture animal biomass. So some of the disadvantages include the cost of filtration devices, mechanical complexity, and the space requirement of the filtration. So increased filtration and energy consumption leads to higher startup and operational costs. The lower startup cost and potential nutrient cycling of biofloc system is the new technology people looking at now. So, according to the Tinieri and Ray 2018, NO3 level can continuously increase over time in the clear water. The continued function of nitrifying bacteria in the clear water system was indicated by the consistent accumulation of nitrate in those systems. So, in the biofloc system, nitrate concentration decreased substantially. This might possibly be due to the bacterial or agar assimilation of nitrogen into the cell. Although nitrate is much less toxic than ammonia and nitrite, continued nitrate accumulation as a result of nitrification can inhibit the shrimp growth and survival. So traditional recirculating aquaculture systems rely on efficiency of solid removal and fixed film nitrification to maintain the water quality. But unlikely most of the commonly cultured finfish species, Leptinus baname is a dentitivore and is capable of deriving a significant portion of its nutrient from the decomposing organic matter. There is an evidence that Leptinus baname are not able to realize their full growth potential in a clear water systems that are lacking significant quantities of organic detritus for the shrimp to feed upon. So shrimp maintained in clear systems did not grow as well as shrimp maintained in the pond water, even when fed with high quality pelleted diets. So the faster growth rate of shrimps maintained in the pond water were attributed to the presence of organic detritus and algae suspended in the pond water. It is not that I'm saying biofloc is better for shrimp, but it depends on your preference too. Biofloc of course could reduce the feed conversion ratio and limit the water exchange. However, a biofloc system will have potentially high total suspended solid. High total suspended solid concentration could limit the shrimp growth in the biofloc system as compared to the clear water recirculation system. The good shrimp productive performance in the clear water recirculation system would be due to the good water quality maintained by the water recirculation. There are also studies reported that shrimp harvested from recirculating aquaculture systems have higher weight compared to the biofloc system. However, from Esparza et al. 2015 study, the survival rate still makes no significant difference in these box systems. So in conclusion, while RAS production has increased in popularity, there is still a need to improve production systems and reduce operational limitations. So overall, shrimp farmer managers should consider the potential for faster shrimp growth, consistency in water quality dynamics, and the cost of equipment and energy when deciding what system to use. So I hope the explanation in this video will help you to make a better decisions before you start your own shrimp farming. We also prepared a free ebook for those who wish to learn more on the vertical mud crab farming. Download it in the link provided in the description. And if you're interested to join the course, you can drop us a message. Thank you for watching.